Hi, I'm MATHRoberg, and today we're going to learn to rewrite conic sections in this form into this form. Now, these top three blue equations are conic sections written in standard form. In standard form, conics are really easy to identify which conic section it is, and they're also easy to graph. So this is an ellipse, and a parabola, and a hyperbola. Now, even though this red one represents a conic section, it's what we call an equation, a general equation of degree 2. And it's difficult to determine which conic section it is, and also how to graph it. So our goal today is to rewrite things in this general second degree form into standard form. Now the process we're going to use to do this involves completing the square, a topic you learned about whenever you learned to solve quadratic equations. If you don't know how to complete the square, you're not going to be able to do this process. So I've put a link to a good video in the description of this video on how to complete the square. So you may want to check that out before proceeding with this video. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do here is we're going to group the variables. By grouping the variables, it means we're going to put all the x's together, all the y's together, and all the constants together. So let's start with the x's. We have x squared minus 6x, and let's leave a little bit of space. That's all the x's. So then we go to y. We have plus 4y squared minus 16y. And the only thing we have left that we haven't really moved around is that 21. It's a constant because it doesn't have a variable. We're going to want to move all the constants to the other side of the equation. So we can do that by subtracting 21 from both sides of the equation. So we're going to end up with a negative 21 on this side. Okay, we've grouped the variables. The next thing we need to do is factor out any coefficients on the x squared terms. So on the squared terms, sorry. On x squared, there's a 1 coefficient. So when we factor that out, it won't really make a difference. So we're just going to rewrite it with parentheses and leave a little space for our completing the square. Now the y squared term has a 4 in front of it, so we need to factor out that 4. When we factor out 4, we get y squared. Factor out the 4 from the negative 16, and we get negative 4y. Leave a little bit of space for completing the square, and this all still equals negative 21. Okay, so far we've grouped the variables, and in the next step we factored out any coefficients of the squared term. The next step is actually completing the square. So, completing the square involves taking half of the b coefficient, we call it, and squaring it. So half of negative 6 is negative 3, square that, you get positive 9. Now if I add 9 to this side, in order to keep my equation balanced, I need to add 9 to the other side. Up until this step, all I've done is move things around and factored. But when I added 9 to the equation, I actually changed it. So to keep the whole equation balanced, I added 9 to the other side. So I've completed the square here. Now as far as y is concerned, let's see. Half of negative 4 is negative 2. Square that, you get positive 4. And here's something kind of tricky. When I added 4 to this side, I didn't actually add 4. I added 4 times the 4 that I factored out. So what I ended up actually adding is 16. So let's add a 16 to this side. So why didn't that happen here? Well, because we had a 1 on the outside. Our coefficient of the x squared term was 1. 1 times 9 is 9, so I just added 9. 4 times 4 is 16, so I had to add a 16 to that side. All right, now when I simplify everything, let's see where we're at. When I completed the square, I can rewrite this as x minus 3 squared plus 4. I completed the square here, so now my perfect square trinomial factors to y minus 2 squared. And then on this side, let's see. Negative 21 plus 9 plus 16. Well, 9 and 16 is 25, so I think I'm going to end up with a 4 here. It's starting to look like a standard form of a conic section. Looks like an ellipse. So, if this is an ellipse, we'd need a 1 on this side. So let's divide everything by 4 to get a 1 on this side. When we simplify, we end up with 3, quantity x minus 3 squared divided by 4, plus the quantity y minus 2 squared equals 1. So this would have a denominator of 1, but we omit that. There we go. Here's an ellipse centered at 3, 2. Let's do one more example. Let's try 25x squared plus 4y squared plus 50x minus 24y minus 39 equals 0. Now you may want to try this one really quick. Pause the video, try it, and see if you get the same answer as me. So the first thing I'm going to do is group the variables. Next, I'm going to factor out the coefficients of the squared terms. Next, I'm going to complete the square. Being careful that whatever I add on this side of the equation, also add on the other side. Next, let's just simplify. Looks like we have an ellipse again. I need to divide both sides by 100 to get that 1 on this side. And there we have it. An ellipse centered at negative 1, 3.